Recording. Everybody, so if it is all ready, then can we go ahead now? Everyone?
Yes.
Everybody, so I'm sharing my screen now. And as you know it very well, from today onwards, we are starting up our Angular part, okay, which is one of the most important topic of this entire session. And this will take a lot of time because we'll be going in depth about an Angular to understand how it works, how it enhances, and what it does. So, first thing what we need two things. Okay, Node.js and VS Code Editor. Let me try to. What we require? Node.js. And these two softwares we really need it before we proceed ahead. I'm sure this will be anyways there because from last so many days we are working on this editor, Node.js, which requires additional. So please confirm whether we have a Node.js with us. Just type yes if you have it. Okay, may I know the version? So you open your terminal and type. And let me know the version which you have it. Everyone. So how many if you don't have? Please tell me answers in a chat, please, by typing no if you don't have this. Yeah, version 14 would be fine. So those who do not have, I quickly tell you, you can click on Node.js download and download this version. Because I tell you which version you need it now. I need Node 14. So we go to the previous releases. We can take Node version 14, whichever you want. Okay, so previous versions you can go and download this. And let me know if you are all ready, please. Yeah, Jayesh, it'll work. That's fine. But sometime incompatibility issue comes. So that's what I'm trying to say. Like having Node version 14 would always be, you know, better. Okay, first thing what we have to do is, everyone, we are going to work on, so we're going to work on Angular. So we have to start installing the Angular system into our program. Okay, and we would like to continue accordingly. Yeah, Hari, I just would like to answer your question as you're saying, what is the necessity of Node.js? So let me brief you about that. See, first need to understand, I tell you about an Angular first, then I will tell you about the scope of Node.js here. So we need to understand that Angular is basically known as called what? It's a front-end framework, okay? What do you mean by SPA? Single page application. So when we talk about an Angular, what is an Angular? Everybody, it is a framework, okay, which intend to develop what a single page application. Okay, so since it Angular is a framework, so it comes with a lot many libraries, it comes with a lot many APIs. For that, it requires a support of what? Node.js. What is a Node.js? It is a platform. What is that? It is a platform to develop apps. Clear? It is a platform to deliver a server-side app. So Node.js give you the platform to develop an Angular application, like how you have the complete platform, like in Eclipse, Java. These are all what? These are all basically different type of platforms. Node.js is also type of platform which is going to give you the kind of environment where your Angular libraries can be done with the setup and all. So normally, if you see, the Node.js has got no direct relationship with Angular, but Angular is purely dependent on Node.js, because Node.js is going to give you the kind of environment where you can start working on an Angular-based application. So Angular is purely based on Node.js, but Node.js is not depending on Angular. I hope, Hari, you are clear. Okay, so it's a kind of systematic way how your application is going to work. So Node.js is the primary requirement, and then we, on the top of that, we go with what? With your Angular. You need to also understand that Angular, okay, is a component centric framework. What is an Angular? It is a component-centric framework. If I ask you, okay, so ideally, component means somewhat view. It is a view-centric framework. But traditionally, when you develop a view, you develop an HTML pages. No, Hari, there is no necessary that the both version must be same. Not necessary. Your Angular can have a different version, because right now the Node.js version is what? 16. Are we clear? But Angular version is right now what? 13. Yeah. So not necessarily that version needs to be compatible. But it's always good. We need to have version 14 to support Angular 10 and above. So we are talking about, guys, a component means what? A view. So view doesn't mean that you're talking about what? A typical traditional HTML based page. It is a micro view. It is not a traditional web page where you see the complete head sections, title section. It is just a view which is minimalistic to the specific target. Suppose if you see the Facebook guys are what? It is a single page application. The idea behind a single page application. is to develop your app which works consistently across multiple devices, like in desktop, laptop, mobile, anywhere. Okay, without having any flaw. The application renders fast too. Okay, so a lot many things which are there, which I'll be discussing with you one by one. But ideally, I'm telling you that we're using what component and what is the core language? Core language of Angular is basically what? TypeScript. We don't use JavaScript. Instead, we use what? TypeScript, which is a superset of JavaScript. Okay, internally, Angular uses a compiler, okay, which convert. So TypeScript cannot be understood by any browser. Are you getting my point? TypeScript cannot be understood by any browser. So you really need what? Everyone. Some transpiler, which will transpile your TypeScript into what? Into JavaScript. TypeScript is basically taking the complete JavaScript experience to the next level so that you can develop some more convenient application which is better and fast to load. Okay. I'm sure that we guys are now understood about what Angular really does, and we will be exploring more about an Angular on a step-by-step manner. Okay, but before I move on, Raman, I've already shared that link, but if you want, I can share that link again with you. You can take from here. See, Hari, the real-time disadvantages you talk about, sorry, the disadvantage of not using Angular is basically like Angular is a proper sorted framework, where it takes your problems and offer the best solution of that. If you do not use Angular, you maybe end up with using what? Multiple libraries to sort out your issue. Clear? So Angular is a one-stop shop where all different type of problems are going to be sort in a one single loop. Okay, like suppose libraries like in jQuery, YUI, Dojo, Prototype, these all libraries are functional libraries. These libraries are intended for serving a specific purpose, but they would not serve the whole purpose in a single umbrella. Angular, if you use, it becomes a demand in the industry, because using this Angular, you can develop your application which are more intuitive and more lightweighted and fast to load. Are we clear? Where your involvement on writing functionalities of function programming going to be reduced, and you're going to be more productive hour by hour. So let the training begin. You will get more benefit automatically by your own, or rather INX, because see, I will explain as per my experience. But when you start implementing it one by one, you will start automatically counting all the advantages by your own. Okay, there are many websites nowadays have shifted to the single page application mode, because you are no longer a desktop user. Okay, we are no longer desktop users. We are now mobile users also. So if I ask you to go back and create a separate website for Angular, is it feasible? Or if you're an iPad user. So I want a one framework and for multiple devices. That's what the whole idea. So angular.io, it's an official website. What it is saying, develop across all platforms. You can see deployment target for web, mobile, native, and native desktop. So you do not need to go back and learn 10 different things. This one itself have got multiple advantages. You can see the speed and performance because it loads pretty fast. I'll be clear to get a lot of libraries inside this. Incredible tooling. You talk about VS Code Editor and a lot of other tools. And thousands and hundreds of companies are basically using this to cut down the overall development time. Okay. So what do we need it? It's step number one is everybody. So you go and create a new folder under your C drive or D drive and give the name called what? Come on. And then say, so after you say series space, angular space, train, after going to the C drive, you people have to go and type another code. And say, see, NPM stands for what? NPM stands for node package manager. This is the tool which comes automatically with Node.js, which will be primarily meant for downloading all the necessary required dependency for your project and take care about running it and launching it. So it is an inbuilt tool, NPM. So I stand for install. I stand for what? Okay, npm space I space @ and what we're doing now, we are asking for the specific version of Angular CLI. Okay, @ angular/CLI, this is the version we're looking forward for, and -g. G stand for what? Global installation, so that it can be accessible across different folders. So this is the first command we need to execute it. And this will take some few seconds. Once this command is ready, but remember one thing, you have to go inside this folder first, Angular Train. So create a new folder, go inside this and execute this command and type done in a chat window, please. Again, I'm repeating, your first few minutes are very, very important. So please be interactive and help me if you are done.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, I could I could not actually understand. Should we first download Angular package and then we have to run this, or we can directly run it?
No, nothing like that. Did you download this?
No, not yet.
So you have to download it because this command won't work unless you downloaded that. So you have to download this particular one, install it, and then this command is going to work for you. Otherwise, it would not.
Okay, because when I actually go into that site, the download only mentions or lists down all the packages.
So you have to pick up the according to your convenience, according to your platform architecture. If you're using Linux, if you're using Windows, so pick up accordingly.
No. the link that you mentioned, if I go into that link, it is just displaying all the folders. So which particular link I have to download, or do I have to download the entire thing?
No, it's not about entire thing. See, when you talk about any of those, see, I'm getting this Windows 64.zip. Are we clear? So you have to click on this. Are you using 64-bit machine or
yes,
Windows?
64.
You have to click this, or else you can click this. Can you see this MSI?
Right.
Click on this MSI. The moment you click on MSI, it will download, and after that you will get a binary file. Just send, click, and it will ask you to installation step. Next, next, next you do, and installation will get over.
Okay.
Okay. And then this command will work for you.
Okay. Using that command from which we can run it, and we'll have to run it on the same directory, which we have created right now.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. Thank you.
So friends, please make it and do let me know once you are done.
Hello. Hello.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wait. So I'm asking, like, why are we using Angular 10 when it is about to, like, the LTS is about to end in this month only?
See, it is not about that. I'm talking about a flexible version.
No. So what version will we be using?
We are using this CLI version. We are using.
No, no. CLI what version? 10. You are using Angular 10, right?
Yeah, we are using CLI version 10.2.1, which is a stable version.
Yeah, but the LTS is about to end this month.
Doesn't matter, but the feature is going to be remain same.
So why are we not using new? Like, I need to understand that, because I have already developed in Angular like 7, 8, 9. So like, I thought this training would be like about the latest one. So that is why I was more interested in this.
See, your new features will be covered. Don't worry about that. We will be upgrading those versions. Okay, so whatever versions as per their mention inside this TOC, this all will be covered. Don't worry about this.
Okay.
But please remember, since you may be knowing about the previous versions, but we'll be starting from the scratch only. Okay.
Okay.
Yes, everybody, let me know once it is installed and ready for everyone. Don't forget to type done once this first command is ready for everybody. You're all done, then what you need to do next step is, everyone, once this installation is done, so the next step will be, you have to use ng. Ng will be the first command for the Angular, and after that you'll be using this next command called new. So new means I want to develop a new project, and then after that you have to use the project name, and I'm saying my hyphen app. This will be a project name, and this will be running under the same folder called Angular Training. And once you done, it will be asking few questions with all of you. Again, I'm repeating, when you run this command, it will be asking you a few questions. Just keep saying enter, enter, enter. Don't check or uncheck anything. Just keep pressing enter. After this command, you are executing it, there will be few questions would get asked. So just keep saying neck, just enter, 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 enter. Don't check or uncheck anything and get going. And let me know once you're ready. Again, I'm requesting you, nobody will select anything. Just keep pressing enter after every single question is asked. By default, options and continue. And let me know once you're ready.
Hello.
Yeah.
While installing Node.js, I have been encountering multiple errors. So is that okay?
Yeah. Continue.
Okay.
Hello, sir.
So let me know once you're ready.
So actually, I just want to ask one thing. While install that Node.js, which thing that you select in the tree, at Node.js runtime or npm package manager?
Which one you are saying?
While installing the Node.js, actually I have installed, but I have uninstalled again because I wasn't able to run this command in that Node.js. So when we install the Node.js, which one you have to select? Node.js runtime or npm package manager?
Can you share your screen?
Yes.
Yeah. Tell me which one you're saying.
This one.
Yeah. I'm just fine. I'll just go back. Yeah. Just say next. Just select whatever it is coming up as a by default.
Which one?
The default was the first one?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, keep continuing. Just say next, next, next. And that's it.
And actually, I have created folder in the D drive. Angular drive, right? This one.
Yes. And once installation is over, you can open the command prompt once the installation is over. Okay. And continue the same. Just to finish, open the command prompt.
CMD.
Yeah. Go inside this folder where your Angular training is.
Hi, create my folder, the Angular train.
Yeah, the rest of the commands should be executed from here.
Okay. Achha, okay.
Share my screen, then follow the
Yes, train. Sir. Okay.
So these are the commands we have to execute it.
Okay, sir. Okay.
So guys, do let me know by typing done once your installation is over.
Hello. Hello.
Yeah. While executing that command ng new my app, so first option by default it asks for a question. Would you like to add Angular routing? It took
that is what, by default. See, that's what I said. Whichever options are coming up, just keep pressing enter.
Yeah, yeah. So by default it took an option as no. Is it okay?
Yeah, that's what I said. Whichever options are coming up, just keep pressing enter and select the by default options.
Okay.
Saying something?
Yeah.
Yeah, please continue.
It's showing me semantic workflow
pain. Your voice is cutting down. Could you please tell once again?
Semantic workflow pain. It's showing me the error.
What error?
Semantic workflow pain. Paste the error in chat box.
But that I can't understand unless I see your screen. So can you share your screen?
Okay, I will share my screen. Yeah.
Lakshmi, could you please follow the rules from your command prompt rather than internal terminal? Use a command prompt normally and go ahead and use the same.
That's it. I'm facing the same error.
Yeah, go inside the new folder which you created, Angular Training. Can I take a look to your folder first? Just open your folder.
So that standard format we have to select that CSS, right?
Yeah. Okay, so do one thing here. Just open your terminal. Open your terminal. Yeah. And say npm space I. npm space I, hit enter. Okay, now you say cd space my app. First you say cd space my app.
What?
I'm saying cd space my app, the folder name.
Oh. Okay.
And now you say npm space I. One thing, what it's saying, just say npm space I space hyphen hyphen force. No, npm space I space hyphen hyphen force.
Force.
Enter. Now it will work, but it's taking some time to download. So once it is done, you'll be writing the direct command, which I will tell you now. Okay. So can I share my screen now?
Yeah.
Okay. Everyone, so once you see this message for ngSpace NewSpace my app, if everything goes fine, just type this command call. cd space my hyphen app and just use the command name called what ng space. So this will launch your application by launching the internal server, and after that open your browser. Okay, in your browser type localhost colon 4200. That is the port number where your server will be launching your application. Just check and confirm if it is working fine. Friends, if you are ready, please. I'm waiting for the others. So friends, if it is ready and working, so what you need to do, if you just open your VS Code editor, everybody, and then just go to your file menu and say open folder. There'll be one option coming up called open folder, and select the folder. Okay, select the folder of your Angular, the one which you've recently created called my app. And when you open the folder, so you should see the folder structure just like that, the way I'm having it right now. Clear? So deleting some additional folders like that. Okay, so we'll be getting this folder structure like that. Just confirm if it is.
Sir, we need to install this. What is this Visual Studio means?
Which one you are saying?
The application which I have opened. So it is a Visual Studio. Which one?
That is the folder, the one which you have opened. That is the My App folder, the project which you recently created. The folder I have opened it here.
But in which application you have opened this?
VS Code Editor. That's what I asked this question to you earlier in the morning.
I have joined a little bit late. Okay. Can you just tell me which one it is so I can install it?
This one, VS Code Editor. You can download this also.
VS Code Editor, right? Okay.
Done.
So that first link which I can see, code.visualstudio.com. So in that I can download, right?
Yeah, you can.
Okay.
So friends, are we all good to go? I'm sure like everybody is all set and getting the similar folder structure, the one which you are having it right now. Now, in this folder structure, a few things you need to understand. And what's that? In this complete folder structure, you see the folder structure like an SRC. You're getting it? We have got SRC, we have got app folder. Okay. So here in our app, we have got this other folders like in, you know, index.html file, app folder. So normally what happens, as I said, Angular is a what? Is a component-centric architecture. Okay, so we are talking about an Angular is a kind of what? A component-centric architecture. Okay, so we need to develop a components. So since Angular is a component-centric architecture, so you need to understand few things. When you open the folder structure, you will see the folders like that. You guys have got app component right now, app folder. Okay, you have got SRC folder, you have got index.html file. Okay, so this component called app.component.ts, okay, that's the main folder which is actually playing an important role while developing your applications. Clear? So this component is by default created when you have created a new project. And this is your index.html file. So normally when you see your browser have got lot many tags kept in by default, but you need to understand while working with your Angular. Okay, so your HTML, when you open that, Okay, so this is your HTML page. So your HTML page looks like a very basic, but the contents what you see in your browser, they are way different compared to what you see in an index.html file, correct? Everybody, correct?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, when you open the localhost 400, that is the first file which you get picked up by your server, that is called index.html file. Yeah, so how the component-centric architecture really works. So let me try to draw one small diagram to get you the feel of what we're trying to say. Everyone, just watch it carefully. How the component-centric architecture really works. See, in your Angular, your components are basically divided with three important aspects. One is called what? Index.html. Second is what? And third is what? Component TS file. So there are total three components are there. Sorry, not components, I would say three areas are there on your component. TS file. And this is what the CSS file. So this is what your component look like. It. I can give the component name called what? Web component. Okay, so this component contains three portions: CSS, which is designed for the presentation, index for displaying the data, and TS, which provides the actual data. And this is what, everybody, what is this? And this is the place where component getting added. Are you clear, everyone? This is where your component is getting added. So when the client tries to access your application, are we clear? He or she actually gets what? Everybody, index.html. But the contents what he see in your browser, it's not a part of index.html file. It comes from where? Everybody, component. So every single component, what will be creating it, they will be having these three aspects. Okay. Earlier in a previous version, we could have only one file, which could have accommodated index HTML content as well as the CSS content. We could have only this TS file, but I personally feel it's not a good idea to develop everything under the TS file. So you should have a separate for CSS and separate for template. That's why we have splitted those files. This component internally need a data. See, index HTML require the data to be displayed. It provided by whom? TS. So TS provides all the methods and the data which HTML will consume. Okay. But ultimate data comes from the backend. Where's your backend? Everybody, where is your backend?
Node.js.
You can have a Node.js. You can also have called what? Your Spring Boot microservices, whatever you have developed it. So your backend will be available here. This database. But you would not be connecting with this database directly. Instead, you'll be having what? Everybody, instead you'll be having what? It may be developed using java.net or php. Okay, so this REST API, if you want to connect it, you require one intermediary code, and that is nothing but call what? That is called what? It is a layer provided by the Spring for, sorry, this Angular 2 was. So your component interacts with whom? Service. Service will in turn interact with so friends, this is the flow of your application. I hope you're all clear. Yes, everybody, please confirm, are you all clear with the flow? Because remember, this is the same flow we will be using yes, throughout our project yes. learning.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hey, can you just please explain what exactly is a service? Because
service
we know
is,
about REST API and service, yeah.
So service is basically a layer provided by the Angular application only. It is a reusable class.
Okay.
Okay. Suppose you tomorrow come back and create one more component name called what? So this login component once again interacts with what?
Okay, so a single service will be catering to multiple components.
Yeah, you can have a one single service, you can have a group of services. Choice is yours.
Okay. Okay, yeah, thank you.
Yeah. So everybody, this is the diagram which you have it. So I want you to just be very, very clear about what we're doing it. So accordingly, you can understand the flow. So friends, are you all clear about this architecture? Because if you're clear about architecture, development won't take much time. But architecture is something where the people don't realize, but later on they get confused and they really don't understand what is going on. So you must be very clear. Okay. All good, everyone. So in your component, what you need to do is, in this index.html file, you have one component name called what? app.component.ts, okay? So in this app.component.ts, if you open, which is there under which folder? Under the app folder. So this app.component.ts, you see there's an option called selector name app root. So you will see this name both are same. Isn't it everyone?
Yes.
So that means you are making that particular component available to the index.html file which satisfies this need. But your component also have a call what? One HTML page also. So what is your HTML page name? Come on. Everyone? Okay. So that's how the program is. So what you need to do, just open this app.component.html. So you might have a lot of code written. So remove everything and write a very simple tag called welcome and save your file and see whether you're also getting the same outcome as like in mine or not.
how do we open it in browser from this editor itself?
Which you saying?
We have I've written it as welcome, but how do I directly open it?
You can't open it directly. Your browser is anyways running under the localhost 4200. So once you say localhost 4200 here, you will see this page.
Okay. In terminal, you can use the hyphen hyphen, or then it will be directly open to the browser.
Sorry, I didn't get what you said.
Like if you want to open instead of browser, you can provide that command in V or hyphen hyphen O, then it will be automatically opened in the browser.
Your voice is not very much audible. What are you saying?
In V search hyphen hyphen O, it will automatically open in the browser.
Yeah, that can be also open in a browser.
How do we check the local host port on which port it is running?
Because by default it is running under the same port. You can see here when you're running your application, it will tell you here that the server is launched under 4200. It will be mentioned.
Yeah, I'm actually not able to check that terminal tab.
Sorry?
I'm not able to check that terminal tab which you are having.
You can just see the command prompt instead. In a command prompt, you would see when you're launching your application very first time.
Okay.
Okay, so you see this message called welcome is appeared. Everybody, please confirm if you're able to see.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that's what your first component, which you have it right now. So the component which you have, are we clear? So this component is now accessible directly to your backend application. Well, everybody, so before we proceed ahead, can we go and take a break now? Yes, everybody? Yeah, so we are going to declare a break for 15 minutes. We'll see you back after that and to resume. Okay, thank you. Hello everybody, so are we all back from the break? Please confirm. Hello everybody, please confirm, are we all back from the break? Okay, so let me share my screen again. Well, so the component is ready with me. Now you need to understand one more important thing in this architecture. When you have seen this project, okay, so you might have realized is something we have created. The component is one file called app.module.ts. Do you see this app.module.ts file, everyone? So this app.module.ts file, everybody, this app.module.ts file is the file which is responsible to define as a directory for the entire component, whichever you have it now. So if you have all the components, you might see this component is already added here inside where? Under the declaration stack, name called what? App component. It will be available here also. Where? In your declaration stack, it will be also available where? In a bootstrap. Getting it? So this is the by default directory, which is holding all your components. So when you're creating a component, it is an important that your components are declared here. Under which location? Under the declaration stack. Well, bootstrap means which component will be launching at the time of loading your page. So I've given which component name? App component name. So this component will be available where? In your index.html file. Clear, everyone? So let's go back and create a new component into my application. Under my src, I'm going to create another folder here. Please everybody take a look, main app, under the app folder only. Inside the main app, I'm going to create a new file, name called. Mainapp.component.ts. And I'm creating one more file called. So we have these two files to be get created, TS and HTML file. TS file, when we create, we always start working with the class called export class main app. Okay. And this class will contain nothing but is a small message called it's just property name. Above this, you have to define one annotation called @ component. And you can see now the moment you add the component, immediately you can see it comes from which package here, everybody. Hit enter, and it comes from which package? Angular core. Clear? So this component will require two things. One is called selector name. Selector name is very important because this is the name through which your component will be uniquely identified. I'm giving the selector name is called to what? And the next thing is your URL name of template. I'm saying template URL is what? And in this main app.component.html file, okay, I'm adding what? So we have got these files available with us. okay, through which we are trying to launch our application. So once it is ready, so just save your files, but your component which you have created, it has no relationship with anywhere. So make sure this component get declared under where? Under your app.model.ts. So under app.model.ts, you'll be basically adding which file here? Under the declaration stack, which component name? Everybody, can you see this now? Main app, it is saying auto import. See, the component is automatically imported. So step number one, you have to create a TS file and then the HTML file and create this, add this component under where into the declaration stack. And once it is added, so you have to make this component as a child of the app component. So you come here and say what? What is the main app? It is a selected name of what? Of main component. It is saying this, you're ultimately making the main app as a child of what? Sorry, your main app as a child of what? As an app component. That's it. And when I launch my browser, see this now, the component is also available to me. Everyone, are you all here? Everybody, please confirm, are you all clear?
Yes.
Friends, I request you to all please put your answers in the chat if you all are clear, please. Because I told you earlier also, so interaction is very, very important. So please help us if you all are clear. So please go back and create the same component and let me know by typing done in a chat window, please. What I did is I first created this component under the which folder? Under the main app. Under the app. Okay, or main app, wherever you want to basically create a new folder. Okay. And after this component is folder is created, what you have to do here? What you have to do here? You have to basically create this component. Give the selected name, template URL, create your HTML page like this. Okay. And declare this component under where? Under the declaration stack. And last but not, define this component as a child of app component. That's it. Are you clear, Jayesh? Only three steps process. Guys, once it is done, do not forget to type done in the chat. Please confirm if the code started working. I'm waiting for all of you, please.
Can you just show the model.ts?
Sorry?
Model.ts. Actually, it is giving me some error. Can I share my screen?
May I know what is the challenge?
Actually, in command prompt, it is showing that error in that app.model.ts, and it is giving some path is not a model. That the main app.component.ts is not a model. It is showing like that. Can I just share my screen? Or...
Yeah, please share your screen.
It is shown like this.
Can you restart the server again? Stop the server. But meanwhile, I want to see your app.module.ts also first.
Yes, sir.
I think you do not need from SRC, I think. But anyways, you did it, you imported it manually or it happened automatically?
No, it's happened automatically. I just declared here a main app.
Just restart the server. Just a control C here in terminal. Yeah, control C. Enter. Yes.
Why? Yes.
Why? Yeah, okay. Why? And now you say ng serve again.
ng serve, right?
Yeah.
Okay. It is showing like this that main app.component.ts is not a module.
Which application? main app.component. Can I see this main app.component file? Selector main app. I think you forgot to save one file which you haven't saved. Which file it is? Just go to the file menu and say save all. Go to the file menu on the top. File menu above. Yeah, and say save all. Just check the terminal again. See?
Okay, now it is okay. It is compiled. So I mean, what are the folder we have created? So we have to just save all and then.
Yeah, just refresh. Okay, but I think there's still a challenge. Just right click on your browser. Inspect. And say console. There is an error. Let's say compiler not loaded. I think you might have taken some wrong package inside your application. Okay.
Which one you have to take, sir?
Component is fine. Just show me the app module. I think line number, wait. That seems okay. Okay, can you just remove the line number 6? And after line number 11, press say control space, enter, save. See, it came on the top browser. You see your browser.
I can,
but you did not, because you, but main app you didn't make as a child of app component. So just open the main app component.ts, copy the selected name main-app, copy this name main-app.
Okay,
go back to the app.component.html. After that, press enter, opening tag, paste it, close it, save. And see the browser below.
Yes. Yeah, I can see. You go to main app. Okay.
Got your problem, Rohit? Solved?
Yes. Sir, can you just tell me in short about this TS and HTML means we have add?
See, I told you about an architecture. TypeScript is, see, every component have two important aspects. In fact, three. TS file, HTML file, and CSS. CSS provides the data. And templates represent the data and CSS beautify the data.
Okay.
That's what. So whenever you create a component, these files are important to have. Okay.
So it is a TypeScript. This is that HTML page we will show.
Yeah.
And all we have to add in this app model.ts.
Yes, it is a rule.
Okay. Right. And sir, what is we are writing here in class name?
Yes, I will describe it to you now in a while. What is that?
Sure.
So everyone, please confirm in the chat if you all are ready now. Everybody? I'm waiting for all of you to kindly confirm. Okay, now you need to understand here.
Hello.
That, tell me.
Yeah, actually, I missed some of that conversation. I had another call. Can I get this recording so I can catch up?
Yeah, you will get it. you will get the recording by today. Okay. So friends, what happened here in your code, according to the diagram, what happened here? Everybody, according to the rule, what happened here? Which component it is? Everybody, which component it is? App. Which component it is? Everyone, which component it is?
Main app.
Friends, are you getting it? Okay. So what is this? Come on. Okay, so we have all the So what you are having it now, you have a call, that is the client index.html page. Index.html page is available to him. This component is added here. And main app is a child of what? Everybody, main app is a child of what? App. So main app is become a child of app by attaching which selector name? Come on. Everybody?
Main hyphen app.
So this selector name is what? What is this selector name is? So this app root you're adding it where? Come on, everybody. This app root you're adding it where?
Index.
I see. Okay. And this app root you're adding it where? Come on. Are we clear? So main app means what? This main app has become the child of app. Are we clear? And this app has become a child of what? Index. So this is how you made it. Guys, are you clear with the flow or not? Everyone, please confirm. Are you all clear with the flow?
Yes.
Okay. Can I give you one task now? Everybody, please confirm. Can I give you one task now?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So the task is like this. Please watch it. I want you to go back and create two more components. Okay. This component name should be what? Come on. Friends, are you clear?
Yes.
Like this. Can I make it? What exactly that meaning is? The header and footer will be the child of what? Main app. Can we do this? So please go back and create two more components. One is called what? Header. And second is called what? Footer. Make it as a child of main app. Okay, and I should see the message called welcome to header and welcome to footer. Try this and type done in the chat window once you're ready.
So the process will be same, right? Means you have to create the folder again and two components for each.
Same process.
Hello.
I'm waiting for all of you. Kindly update if it is working fine. So may I know like how you guys have tried this out, everyone? So how you've initiated? So certainly I'm sure that you guys have created a two more folders here under the SRC. Header and footer. So what I'll be doing now is like in main app. And header.component.ts, you're using header. But one thing I would like to say, if you really do not want this message like in welcome to header, what you can do in a header.component.ts, you see this class name, so welcome main app welcomes you, so we can say header welcomes you in this class name, we can use it here. Okay, under the double curly braces. Everybody. So using this double curly braces, you can read the data from your TS file. And this header, whatever we have defined it here, so we can use what? As a child of main app. Okay, everyone. So you'll be able to see the outcome in your browser, but this header is not declared under where? Under the app module.ts. So, this is the message. Everybody, are you all clear? So try this out with the same with the footer and confirm if it is working fine for everybody. Please, last 5 more minutes, finish this off and let me know. I still received only 3 responses from the chat. Please confirm, guys, if you're all done. If you need my help, feel free to let me know, please. Great. So it seems like it is working fine for everybody. So good. Like, they're clear about the initial thoughts of what our application is all about. So remember one thing, app.model.ts will be considered always for your registry. Again, I'm repeating my word, your app module will be always considered for what? For your registry, where you will be registering your applications. Okay, and rest of the portions, like you are aware about, like we know about header, footer, components, whatever we have created it. Okay, and the other aspects, like we were talking, like, you know, this which comes first. So the bootstrap is a tag which is responsible to, you know, load only the specific component whichever you're using it now. The language is what to say. Angular, what we're using it, that is basically the TypeScript. So the code, what we're writing it here in our TS files, these are all basically the TypeScript based. And I will explain more about in our upcoming sessions what it really does. So initially, I wanted to tell you, like, this gives you the kind of the experience where the development feel. Hope you're all clear.
Yes, sir.
Well, everybody, so I'm sure like nobody have any kind of questions. So guys, I'm sure like whatever has been covered today, you all are clear about this Angular initial. So we will talk about more in our upcoming days. So you know that Saturday we don't have any session, so we are directly catching up back on Monday, sorry, on Tuesday. So there we would like to start our journey with the next level. So guys, whatever has been covered, are you all comfortable and clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Everybody, all clear? Perfect. Because I want to go a little slow to make sure like everybody matches with my pace so that later on we can go step by step. Okay. So friends, that's it. We are keeping it for today then. And thank you very much for joining. So we'll see you back on Tuesday again to take this journey ahead. Okay. So thank you and see you back on next week. Enjoy your weekend and have a great day to all of you.
Thank you, sir. Okay? So can you please share this video?
Yeah, it'll be uploaded and Lakshmi will be sharing those videos to all of you.
Sure. Thank you so much, sir.